Energy is critical to the Air Force mission. It's the fuel for our jets and the power that runs our facilities. As facility managers, we count on you to make sure the buildings operate efficiently.
We installed lock boxes on those thermostats to keep people from playing with the temperatures.
Went from four coffee pots down to one coffee pot.
I did find a major contributor, which was an air compressor that was cycling on every 30 seconds, and it was running basically 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and who knows how long.
Just Keesler pays for energy, and it's over $1 million, and that's $1 million that could be going towards supporting that mission.
Vintage buildings and high-rises pose energy challenges for facility managers across Air Force installations. Know your buildings from the inside out and report your findings to the base energy manager.
If our building envelope is not sealed, then all those savings that we're doing is going right out the windows, out the roof.
These windows right here are a great example of a single pane aluminum window that, you know, has outlived its lifetime, and we need to move to a more efficient glazed surface. So that's a great example.
When I can see between daylight between two double doors, you know that that building is leaking a lot of air.
Tighten up your building's envelope with simple solutions. Caulking around the windows, fixing the gaps around the doors, and knowing how the users operate the buildings takes a minimal amount of effort and could save your facility a relatively large amount of energy.
Buildings are systems, and the building envelope is the first and most important system to address to make the building more energy efficient. Those usually pay back the fastest.
Help chart your building's energy deficiencies with energy inspection checklists. Turn off lights where daylight is available. Look around and see if installing reflective window film and blinds will keep your building cooler. And perhaps the easiest thing to do is reduce the number of personal appliances.
HVAC 1 Alpha, EMCS.
If you have energy management control systems at your base, visit the EMCS operator to find out if changing the cooling HVAC schedules will save your facility energy and money.
If you have a building that the occupants work 8 to 5, make sure that the cooling schedule, the AC units and everything are operating appropriately for that window, not 7 days a week, 24 hours. That's a click of a button.
Federal laws require the Air Force to reduce energy use another 15% by 2015. It's a tough goal to meet. We need your help to identify energy saving opportunities and report them to the base energy manager. Be sure to refer to the latest Facility Manager Energy and Conservation Guide produced by the Air Force Civil Engineer Support Agency.
Do we have some hangars here that have one, or should I say 1,000-watt bulbs in them, and they have up to 48 to 50 of them? That's 50 kW worth of power just in a hangar's lighting alone.
Keesler Air Force Base is recouping energy savings rapidly. New energy-efficient lighting and sensors in more than 15 buildings saves the base $340,000 a year. Now, if someone leaves the room, the light sensors will automatically turn the lights off. And this 200-room facility, formerly known as an energy hog, is now an energy jewel, thanks to the new chilled water loop system.
We noticed a more accurate maintenance of temperature in the rooms, in the hallways. The humidity levels have been down.
So I'm looking for fans, radios, coffee pots, refrigerators, that kind of thing, to see if...
Proactive facility managers look at energy inefficiencies and motivate building occupants to help the Air Force save energy. Brochures, displays, handouts, and energy-saving examples are helpful tools to have during commander calls. Monthly and quarterly contests encourage teamwork. Training is an Air Force top priority when it comes to culture change. You can help by providing energy awareness training to the occupants of your building. Eglin Air Force Base developed a computer-based training program available to all bases.
They can get it at their workstations, they can come to the center, or they can get it in their commander's call.
We often think about energy reduction, but don't forget about water conservation. When you inspect your facility for leaking faucets and showerhead flow, don't forget to look around your mechanical rooms and check your irrigation systems. You could be wasting water and energy and not know it. When it comes to changing the culture, try infusing a little conversational humor.
Try to make it fun. We've tried to educate. We use all media that's available. So we'll use the internet, we'll use pop-ups on the computer, we'll use our Eglin Bulletin, we'll use our marquees. You can't over-communicate the importance of energy conservation.
Anybody in here?